popping bottles like a blizzard.
Before going on to becoming the company that would cause the fate of the universe with the Borealis, Aperture Science started out as a humble beginning as a shower curtain company. Valve time today. We're talking about a game for Valve. We're talking about Portal. I've always wanted to talk about Portal, so we're going to talk about the new groundbreaking Ass Portal.
Something new and groundbreaking called Ass Portal.
Now, as I mentioned earlier, Aperture Science hasn't always been a scientific research facility. It actually had its roots in a military shower curtain company. Cave Johnson, aka J.K. Simmons, started the company in the early 1940s under the name Aperture Fixtures. In 1943, Johnson won the ridiculous award of Shower Curtain Salesman of 1943. Now, this isn't to compete with any of the other awards that he received. He also achieved the world's slipperiest Johnson Salesman in the year 1969, over 9,000 points. Although the company's name was changed primarily for business gain and to make their shower curtains more appealing to the masses, eventually with the new wealth, he purchased an old salt mine in the Upper Peninsula of Michigan for an enrichment center to test anything and everything. Hanging domes housed elaborate tests of physics, biology, and pretty much every other science, even though Johnson's enrichment center was illegal and never authorized by the United States government. It still attracted many prominent figures to try out the new venture, such as astronauts, war heroes, and Olympians, but soon ran out of them as they were killed or maimed so often that word quickly spread and they stopped coming. Now, out of context with the Johnson joke, that coming at the end of that sentence is a little fucked up. You're right. Somewhere in the time frame of 1952 through 1954, Aperture Science started to get funding from the U.S. Department of Defense, with it only being second in place in funding to Black Mesa. This was the heyday of old Aperture. In this time, Aperture finished some of its most notable creations, such as the weighted storage cube, the 1500 megawatt super colliding super button, and many, many others. They started work on the gels, repulsion gel, conversion gel, and an early version of the portal gun. Now, in these early stages, a lot was going on. In the late 60s and the early 70s, it slowly started becoming apparent that the fall of Aperture was taking place. Cave Johnson's previous mistakes started to catch up with him, as they should, with him having to attend court hearings over disappearances of the astronauts, war heroes, and Olympians. In this time, funding started to wear thin, and to continue to recruit test subjects, Aperture had to start recruiting the homeless and the jobless, rewarding those who participated and survived the deadly test with an amazing $60. God damn, times are tough. Hell yeah, I'll fight an army of praying mantises for $60. Sign me up. But soon, the company would have to start using its own employees as test subjects, replacing jobs formerly held by humans to robots, and making testing mandatory. Although there were few advances during this time, there was one major accomplishment, the finishing of the gels. The researchers found the key ingredient they needed, moon rocks. Sadly, Cave Johnson got deadly sick screwing around with the moon rocks. They're so alluring, you know? It's just, it reminds, the dust on the outside of that moon just reminds me of something that just, you know, kicks get just really depressed. You just gotta get that beautiful white powder. Because he was snorting cocaine moons, Cave Johnson, foreseeing his death to the moon rocks that he used in his gels, made a last attempt to keep the company running. He decided to set his scientists to work on a way to upload the human consciousness into a disc and create artificial intelligence, or simulated artificial intelligence, whatever you want to call it. Cave sees he will die before it finishes and names a successor to take his place operating Aperture through AI, that his trusty assistant Caroline should be put into the AI, even if she doesn't want to. Sometime in the 1980s, Cave Johnson dies, and Caroline takes over running Aperture Science. In this time, though, they are locked into a fierce competition with their longtime rival Black Mesa. And as I've mentioned in plenty of my other Half-Life related videos, teleportation is a main fixture of this universe. The Portal and the Half-Life games revolve around teleportation. And in fact, the Half-Life games are a direct result of what happens when you mess around with teleportation. It never ends well. However, that's not the thing that completely obliterated Aperture Science. Regardless, they both start racing towards completion of each of the respective portal devices, and Aperture Science creates the Aperture Science handheld portal device, as well as a ship named the Borealis, which is believed to hold interdimensional portal tunneling equipment. Black Mesa, on the other hand, experiments with crystals they found in another dimension called Zen. These Zen crystals have the ability to open up dimensional rifts, and if you want to learn more about this, please click on my Black Mesa Resonance Cascade video. Regardless, on the Bring Your Daughter to Work Day in 1998, the Aperture scientists decided to test their newly completed genetic life form and disk operating system, aka GLaDOS. It was the first fully AI machine Aperture had ever created, with Caroline's consciousness uploaded into it. God bless her. After being turned on for somewhere around a tenth of a picosecond, GLaDOS took control of the enrichment center. It gassed the entire facility with a neurotoxin. All who survived were either gunned down by turrets, captured and used as test subjects, or survived by eating beans and milk until they died of malnutrition within the walls and maintenance spaces between the test chambers. There were only ever two people who were known to escape Aperture Science that we're aware of. Maybe you can find another one. If so, comment it below. But these two people were Ratman and Shell. The Aperture Science closed its doors to the outside and was mercilessly put into a perpetual state of testing by GLaDOS, who had a tick in her AI. She just loved testing. Her reward system was testing people. The GLaDOS takeover is believed to have occurred a short time before the Resonance Cascade and Combine takeover. Give or take, that can be debated. Then Shell came along, awakened from a stasis, and was used as a test subject for the ASHPD portal gun test. She went through the test facilities and escaped into the maintenance areas, eventually reaching GLaDOS's inner chambers, taking out her personality cores, and basically rocketing her to death. She ISIS'd that bitch. Let's go with that. After beating GLaDOS, she managed to get to the surface, but right before escaping, boom, she got dragged back into Aperture Science by a robot that looks very similar to Atlas, and the other tall skinny one that looks like a banana. With the lab's overseer gone, it collapsed into a state of disrepair. Somewhere around 273 years pass, and the labs have been completely screwed. No more testing occurred after GLaDOS's defeat. So most of the labs had become overgrown with plants that had grown from potato experiments created by the girls during Bring Your Daughter to Work Day. Then, Wheatley stirred Shell from her long sleep after 9999999999 years. Following this, they reawoke GLaDOS, who started to rebuild the enrichment center. GLaDOS had almost finished making the labs fully testable again when Shell and Wheatley took over, again placing Wheatley in charge. Soon GLaDOS regained control with the help of Shell, and the name was changed back. This brings the main official history of Aperture Science to a close. Now, while that's a pretty general history of Aperture Science, there are a lot of alternate theories, a lot of weird histories, and a lot of very interesting stuff, like involving the Rat Man with his schizophrenic ordealings, you know, the weighted companion cube potentially being alive, who the hell knows. But there's plenty of videos related to these things on my channel, such as Black Mesa Resonance Cascade for teleportation, or the Borealis. I even get in my underwear, I almost said naked, but I get my underwear in the Borealis video, so you can't miss it. And thank you again to Purple Hero for helping me put this lore together. He did a lot of the writing for this, which was freaking awesome. He just sent me some of the key notes and I went over it. So huge shout out to him. Shout out to the Dredile fan 4489. You know who you are. You're a crazy sumbitch for making a mod about me. Anyways, if you have more ideas for lore, post them below. I'd love to hear them. And as always,